वेलकम टू द वीडियो लेक्चर सीरीज. आई एम अमिया कुमार दास. आई टीच इन द डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ सोशियोलॉजी एट तेजपुर यूनिवर्सिटी. दिस लेक्चर सीरीज विल बी हेल्पफुल टू द स्टूडेंट्स दोज हू हैव एनरोल्ड इन टू द ओपन एंड डिस्टेंस लर्निंग मोड. दोज हू आर ऑल्सो प्रिपेरिंग फॉर द कॉम्पिटिटिव एग्जामिनेशंस दे कैन फॉलो दिस लेक्चर सीरीज. टूडे in this session we will discuss the meaning, significance and the idea of development in sociological understanding. If we look at the concept of development, it has been approached from various disciplines. Different discipline subjects, they have approached this concept differently, but how it is conceptualized, understood, discussed and analyzed in the sub-discipline of sociology of development, that we need to understand and discuss. So to start with, we need to understand what is development. Generally, in common parlance, when we talk about development, it denotes improvement or progress. Both development and sociology as a discipline, they are products of the modern world or modernization process or modernity. We all know how during the time of Enlightenment movement, there was growth of the discipline called sociology. And most of the forerunners and founding fathers of sociology, many of them were concerned and they were looking at the whole idea of change. So this change for the betterment, how change is equated with development, that over the period or over this series of lectures that we are going to have, we will look into it. So both the progress and improvement in a positive manner is conceptualized as development. If we look at the meaning of development, or in common parlance, how it is understood by students, by researchers, by academicians, the potentialities of an object or organism, when these potentialities are released, until it reaches its natural, complete, full-fledged form. In common terms, again, if you look at, development refers to broad processes of change with intentional intervention to achieve progress or growth. If we look at this whole idea of progress or growth, it is inherently related to the idea of development in the modern times or in contemporary times. So there are many other words which are used to denote development. Many often it is used as a synonymous term with development, and sometimes as a substitute to the word development. Many scholars in various fields, they have discussed this idea of development in terms of progress, growth, modernization, so on and so forth. So initially, if we look at the growth of development studies, I'm not coming to that. Development studies in itself is a different discipline these days. Many universities, many institutions, they offer master level program in development studies. Even there are undergraduate courses on development studies. So there is a kind of growth along with the modernization process. And if you look at the history or the genesis of this whole idea of development, many authors, they have used this development, the concept of development with modernization theory, or the process of modernization, they have interchangeably used modernization and development as a concept. Then comes the idea of sociology of development and development sociology. Sometimes we might wonder, we think that what is sociology of development and what is development sociology? Sociology of development is something which is approached from the discipline of sociology using your sociological sense, sociological thinking, and sociological approaches, theories, perspective, so on and so forth. So in this case, sociology of development will be looking at the process of development from sociological perspective. Most of the time, it is approached from a critical perspective. Whereas development sociology, which is something different from sociology of development, is approached in a different manner. Here, in development sociology, we use our sociological knowledge, sociological sense, to optimize the process of development or make the development process better, and how it can be improvised or how it can be implemented in the society so that the poorest of the poor, all the sections of the society can benefit out of this development process. So these two things, sociology of development and development sociology, we need to be clear and understand it very clearly. Then if we look at the three forerunners of the sociologies, mostly the Holy Trinity, these are Karl Marx, Emil Durkheim, and Max Weber. We consider them as the founding fathers or the forerunners of sociology. In this case, if we look at the whole idea of change and development, we can locate these three thinkers as our forerunners of sociology who have contributed immensely to the field of sociology of development, but we need to organize that in our own sense. Then how to understand them? They have interpreted the social change, they have interpreted the transformation from their own viewpoint, using their own perspective. And then they have given the analysis by looking at various social factors. So that their theories, their perspective, because of the constraint of the time, we cannot discuss that in a kind of elaborate manner. But to be very brief, Karl Marx has analyzed the change from the materialist perspective of view, which is called as the dialectical materialism or historical materialism. He is looking at the transformation of the society from period to period on the basis of the relationship, social relationship between people. Then Weber has looked at into the rationality, the idea of rationality, how the rationality, the bureaucracy, the authority, that has changed from the traditional time to the modern times. Similarly, Emil Durkheim, he has also looked at the issue of division of labor, religion, the conscience, so on and so forth. So basically, these three thinkers, they have tried to understand the society and how it had changed from the traditional to the modern. Then the meaning of development. Let us come back to the whole idea of development and the meaning of development. It carries the meaning according to the context. Metaphorically, most of the time it is used to compare it with a kind of map. Like a map is having both the time and the space. Taking these two things into account, a map is formed. Similarly, in a cartographic sense, the idea of development is also could be taken, and we can also analyze like a map. Like the development, we need to understand it is in the context, particular context. Von Hetene defines development in the modern sense implies an intentional social change in accordance with societal objectives. Hetene defines development as an intentional social change. What does he mean? He says that development is to bring out intentional change according to the societal objectives. That what kind of objective we have defined, we have put forward, what kind of objectives. Accordingly, if we are defining the goals, objectives, and trying to bring out the societal changes according to the objectives and the goals, that is called development, according to Hetene. Jan Nieuwenhuis Peters defines development as the organized intervention in collective affairs according to a standard of improvement. What constitutes improvement and what is an appropriate intervention obviously varies according to class, culture, historical context, and relations of power. Development theory is the negotiation of these issues. So here he looks into the concept and categories of class, culture, historical context, and relations of power. So he says that development is the organized intervention in the collective affairs. And how to do it? For whom? It is dependent on certain kind of factors. He says it is class, culture, and the element of power. That would define that what kind of intervention will happen, and that intervention, the outcome, the output, will benefit whom and where. That is the most important question he is trying to reach. Then, if you look at the whole idea of development, it is not static, as we have discussed. It is metaphorically, it is compared to a map. So it is important in this context to look at the changing meaning of development over the time. So development is having various kinds of meaning in different regions, different class, different caste, different religion, different ethnic groups, different language, so on and so forth. So we cannot define development in a singular term. Wolfgang Sachs argues that there has been this semantic confusion brought about by the concept of development. Different persons interpret and understand development differently. Similarly, Gustavo Esteva analyzes the meaning of development both from historical and etymological sense. The metaphor of development which was used specifically in biology and other fields became normal in the 19th century, then the word development gathered different connotation. So, if we look at the word development, it has changed over the period of time. Initially, when it came to the dictionary or lexicon, it carried the meaning in terms of the biology, the means that growth. In certain parts in Europe, also it was like, say, developing a film. Film means this, developing the film after the photographic film. Then in the sense of plant, in botany, if the, from the bird to a flower, it is also kind of development. So in this sense, it was used in the European context. Later, it came to the social sphere. So both Gustavo Esteva and Wolfgang Sack, they are looking at how development has a different kind of history. It originated in a specific context, and then it traveled from the biological and the natural science sphere to the sphere of social science and humanities. So let us look into a tabular form of the meaning of development, how it has changed over the period of time, which was given and analyzed in a very lucid manner in the book Development Theory, Deconstruction and Reconstruction by Jan Nederveen-Peeters. In around 1870, it was latecomers. They were industrialization and catching up. In 1940, the meaning, the paradigm was development economics, and it became the economic growth and industrialization. In 1950, it was modernization theory, and the meaning was the growth of political and social modernization. Then in around 1960s, it was dependency theory, accumulation, and national and autocentric. In 1970s, it was alternative development. The meaning was to human flourishing. Then in 80s, you have human development. You have capacitation, enlargement of people's choices. Then you have neoliberalism, that economic growth, structural reform, which are deregulation, liberalization, and privatization. Then you have post-development in 1990s. Then the meaning was authoritarian engineering disaster. Then in around 2000, it was millennium development goal regarding structural reforms. And then when it could not be achieved, then in around 2015, it was sustainable goal. It approved or it advocated for sustainability. So if we look at the whole trajectory of the development, if we look at the whole trajectory of development, then we can understand how over the period it has changed, the meaning of development has changed, how initially when it started with the colonial period, the whole idea of trusteeship was there. And then it started with modernization theory, when to replicate the Western model. And then you have the dependency theory, which critiques the autocentric approach of the exploitation by the developed world while plundering the third world countries. Then we have the idea of alternative development, when they focused on alternative to the mainstream development. Then we have the social development, human development, capability approach, which emphasized on the flourishing of human essence. Then we have the post-development theory, which criticized and they took a position of anti-development, and then came this Millennium Development Goal, which advocated for the structural reform. Then when they realized that it didn't work, then finally now the paradigm is looking up to Sustainable Development Goal, which argues for sustainability. So there are different trends in development theory. There initially it was the structuralist perspective to more agency-oriented views. The structuralist thought that the structuralist view of development was more on the structure rather than the agency. Even Marxism, neo-Marxism, they were like following the structuralist pattern of agency, structuralist pattern of development, but the agency approach, where they given priority to the agency approach, it was developed after this interactionist perspective or the micro approach, where the importance was also given to the agency at the local level. So this change can, from the structuralist to the agency level, can be also described as a change from deterministic to the interpretative views. And the emphasis, the consequence of the emphasis on the agency, is that development thinking becomes specialized and more local or regional. Then it gave also importance to differentiation and diversity, and in a way various kind of other things came into prominence, like gender, ecology, culture, and the environment. All these things came into the prominence while emphasizing on what should be the model or ideal kind of development, but there were contestation. So another important thing also, it was realized towards the end, and that is what Jan Nederveen-Peeters, he discusses in his book, that it is a kind of holistic approach. So earlier the mainstream development thinkers, they were only considering their approach, which was they thought is superior, while neglecting the local perspective, regional perspective. But later on, because of this kind of negotiation, challenges, contradiction, and friction, various kind of opposing views also took the center stage, and then it was realized that the holistic view, or the views which are contradictory in nature, but they started taking views also into account. In a way, in this lecture, we have seen how development has different connotation, how the meaning of development has changed over the period of time, and now a time has come where we can see how well we can meaningfully visualize, conceptualize, and operationalize the term development, and put this word, put this concept into work, so that it can be useful for the society. Thank you.